Hi, everybody. Joel Colon with Rock Island Auction Company, taking a look at more fascinating weapons from our September 8th, 9th, and 10th Premier Firearms Auction. With me is one of our describers, Seth Isaacson. Seth has an interest and focus on historical firearms. This is another beautiful selection from the September sale, and I can't help but notice that this looks like a particularly old rifle to be having an optic mounted on top.
Yeah, so this is an Edwin Wesson target rifle. Wesson was considered one of the pioneers in using telescopic sights, and in the period, his target rifles were considered among the absolute best. Unfortunately, he died pretty young, but not before training his brothers, Frank Wesson and Daniel Bard Wesson, the latter of course, Smith & Wesson fame. There's even a chance that one of those two brothers had some involvement in the making of this rifle, because they were both trained in their brother's shop. And as you can see, I mean, it's an absolutely beautiful piece. They didn't spare on anything. It's designed for use with a false muzzle, which of course helps with accuracy. It's got even beautiful sculpting lines here on the distinctive bolster. There's beautiful Gustav Jung style, if not Gustav Jung, engraving along the back action style lock, the upper tang, the patch box, the butt plate, I mean, all throughout. It's got a nice piece of wood on it.
And these are, there's a distinct change in tone as well. This is, appears to be a silver Swiss style butt plate and patch box, correct?
Yeah, it's probably German silver, I believe.
German silver? It is an exceptional, and the wood itself, not to mention this the elephant in the room, this massive octagonal barrel, very appropriate for a target rifle.
And if you actually look, it's got a massive barrel, which appears even more massive when you consider the fact that the bore is actually quite small, which is pretty typical for target rifles. And some of these target rifles were even used during the American Civil War by sharpshooters out of New York. Some of the Berdan sharpshooters are known to have brought their own target rifles with, especially early on in the war. So yeah, it's a small caliber, but if you hit your target right, obviously it doesn't really matter how small your bullet is.
So a very historic rifle. These, I imagine, are of great significance to history collectors of that time.
Oh, absolutely, yeah. There's a very similar rifle in the Smithsonian collection that is documented as having been used by a New York sharpshooter. And all the Edwin Wesson rifles are really sought out by collectors. Like I said, he died pretty young, I believe 1849. So these rifles were only made for a short time period. Daniel Bard Wesson continued making them shortly after his death, and then of course got involved in the volcanic firearms and then eventually Smith & Wesson revolvers.
So not just the high art firearms qualify for a museum-worthy piece, and this Wesson target rifle is clear evidence of that. Check out historic firearms like this Wesson rifle in our September 8th, 9th, and 10th Premier Firearms Auction. You can check them out at rockislandauction.com.